So we have started the recording. Now what we will do is we will start with knowing the facts of astrology. So from your perspective, what is the meaning of astrology? What do you feel that what exactly the astrology is?
What I have experienced is astrology is a science to understanding energies, because at the end of the day, everyone, human beings or whatever, is a source of energy. So, and the planets remit those energies. So it's a study of those energies, basically, in astrology. I mean, that's what I believe. I mean, that's what I have experienced.
Yeah. So if we talk about Vedic background, okay. So in Vedic background, we always treat this astrology as Jyotish, okay?
Right.
And there are some scenarios where we cannot do the exact translation of a particular word, okay? So we say, can we translate a Jyotish, which is a quite equivalent meaning of astrology? I don't know. I believe it is not, okay? Right. Because astrology is like... basically, Jyotish is like a light, which is light is one of the things which can directed as a path as well. Okay? When you are in a dark, and if there is a light, then you will see that is the way to go, right? So like that, Jyoti and Ish, it has been divided into two forms, and Jyoti is light, and Ish is Ishwar or God. Okay. So we can say this is a path of God, and or God is trying to show us the correct path in which we should follow. So
right.
Astrology is the important thing. Understanding is that we need to know that is it really a fact or it is what? Okay. So generally what we say is, there are multiple planets are there, okay, and in astrology we always do a calculation which is called geocentric calculation, okay. So geocentric calculation in the sense like we are here in the earth, okay, and all other astrological peripherals are moving around the earth. That is what we believe, okay. So all the peripherals which are there, we treat as them as a planet. Okay? And astrology or Jyotish is that planets or those peripherals, each and everything, even us, we are made of five elements. Pancha Tattva. Okay? So all those Pancha Tattvas are always going to influence each other, because they have hidden vibrations, okay? And if we talk about the planet, we will be discussing that what type of planet we have, but still, a planet is always having a proper meaning. A planet is not really going to explain you in a form of a Jyotish what exactly it is. We say it is Graha. Graha is a substance which is having a grasping power, or it is having a power to influence. So that's why grahas are influencing our life. Lord Brahma and Vishnu and Shiva has given the permission to the all planets to control our life. And due to that, these grahas are influencing our day-to-day activities. And Jyotish is a science where we can use and analyze, or we can say we can calculate their placements. According to that, we can judge few of the events in our life. Why I'm using a word few, because there are multiple events which are happening in our life, but still I believe, yes, if we are astrologer, we will say, okay, yes, we can at least try to interpret about 80% of the events, but still I believe I should treat it as few, because when we are setting a target of, let's say, 40%, and when we reach to a level where 80%, we will always feel happy, right? So if our target or if our goal is 40%, if we reach 80%, we will always feel happy. So like that, I want to treat it as few, but still you will see there are so many things which we can do with Jyotish. But why Jyotish is being introduced, that is very important to know, to understand. The Jyotish is introduced because to understand the karma, why we are here. What is the reason we are here? What exactly the karma is pending, or what karma we need to complete in this life span? So that is the main meaning of understanding Jyotish. But the thing is, nowadays people are using it for different aspects, different reasons, but still Jyotish is capable enough to do those stuff. But if we say why Jyotish has evolved, the reason in the ancient ages, it is because to know why we have born, what is the reason, what karma is pending. Karma is a cycle, okay? Karma is a cycle, and karma always carries its burdens with soul. And soul is controlled by a planet we treat as sun, Atma. So that means soul is carrying the burden of the karma. How we can feel our Atma can be relaxed? So we need to do some karma which are still pending to reduce the burden on our soul. This is what the exact facts about Jyotish. Okay. Now, to learn Jyotish, everybody thinks, okay, we are attending the classes, we want to be an astrologer, we want to make money. But Jyotish is not easy. It seems seriousness to grasp the power of Jyotish. So there are different systems of doing or analyzing Jyotish. If we talk about systems, I can say, like in Western, the people are using some other system. We say as Western astrology. In India, we use like Vedic astrology. And in India, even in Western, probably, I'm not sure, there will be a different branches. But in India, we have different branches. In China, they have their own Chinese astrology. Yeah. But in India, we have different forms of astrology. We say that sages or rishis have carried the knowledge of Jyotish one by one, and they have carried over to their next generation. So Jyotish is carried by the sages. So as you know that when we, let's say I am telling something, I'm trying to explain you something, and when you try to explain the same thing to other people, it will be a different version. Right? Previously what happens is, let's say we still say that, okay, we you can say I have learned from Joy. Okay, I've learned from Joy about astrology. So later, somebody is interacting with some other people called Arun. So probably they will say, okay, I've learned from Arun, astrology. So there was a time where people were naming the system on their own name. So there are some rishis like Bhrigu. The Rishi Bhrigu has formed his own techniques. So there is an astrology which is known as Bhrigu astrology. There is a Rishi named Jamini Rishi. So it also have a different astrology called Jamini astrology. But yes, both of the systems are different of analyzing the Jyotish. But the results are same, because whatever the karma is pending, it is still going to be same, but analyzing, the way of analyzing is maybe different, but the result is going to come same. It can be that I am specialized in using calculator to do the calculation, and maybe you can do the same calculation in computer, but result is going to come the same, right? So like that, when we do astrology, so there are some Jamini astrology, which has been done by Jamini Rishi. Then slowly and slowly, there are different versions came in from each and every aspect of astrology. There are so many branches now. So we stick to astrology form, which is called Bhrigu astrology, which is now known as Vedic astrology, which has been introduced by Bhrigu Rishi. So Vedic astrology is the base of most of the astrologies. We treat it as a base. Maybe Jamini is one of the base, but Jamini astrology or Jamini Rishi came later after Bhrigu. The first form of the astrology is Bhrigu astrology. So we will treat like Vedic is the main form of the astrology. Then if we talk about, there are different other forms which are practiced nowadays. They also are called as Nadi. Nadi astrology. There is astrology which we are trying to learn, that is called KP. KP stands for Krishnamurti Paddhati. Paddhati means a system. Krishnamurti Paddhati is introduced in 19th century. And this is what I believe attracted me a lot. I also been attracted by Gemini astrology. And but still, KP astrology, this is what I am doing practice on very regularly, and I can say yes, still I'm a learner, but still there are so many things I have experienced which is very good in KP astrology. That's why I learn KP astrology day-to-day basis, and also I teach KP astrology. So we will understand what is KP, why we will use KP, and what is the benefit of using KP system of astrology or a Jyotish. So we can conclude that Jyotish is to understand the karma. The karma is carried by sun or atma. So now we will talk about what are the type of planets which we have in Jyotish. Okay. And what are the type of rashis or zodiac signs which we have in Jyotish. So we talk about planets. So we have, we have 9 planets. Okay. So we will start with sun, then moon, Jupiter, Mars, Venus, Saturn, Mercury, Rahu, and Ketu. Okay. So these are the planets which we treat. So physical appearance of the planets, if we say like Sun to Mercury, they all are physical, which we can see from our naked eye. But these are the two planets which we cannot see, but we can sense their power. In KP astrology, these two planets are the most powerful planet which can produce huge impact in our life. They influence other planets. That's why we say Rahu Ketu are the kingmaker in KP astrology, because they can influence and they can grasp a huge amount of power from the different planets if they get connected to in your chart. So if we talk about the Rashis, we always name or number the Rashis with certain name, right? So let's say I will start with Aries. Aries is a sign which is owned by Mars. Okay. Then in the sequence, Aries is also denoted as number one. Then we come to a sign or Rashi which is known as Taurus, which is owned by Venus, which is denoted as number two. If you talk about Gemini, that is owned by Mercury, and it is denoted as number three. Then there is a sign or Rashi as Cancer, which is denoted by number four, and it is owned by Moon. Then we have Leo, which is owned by Sun, and it is denoted by the number five. Then we have Virgo, which is again owned by Mercury. So now we can see the Mercury is owning Gemini and Virgo, and it is denoted by number six. Then we come to a place where Libra is another sign which is owned by Venus. It is denoted by seven. Now Venus is having two signs, which is Libra and Taurus. Okay. So we can say Venus is owning the sign number two and sign number seven. Mercury is owning the sign number three and sign number six. Here sign number six and sign number three. So we can write three and six in front of Mercury. So we'll move on. Then after Libra, we'll come to the sign number eight, which is Scorpio, which is again owned by Mars. So now here we will say, if we in front of Mars, we will say the number one sign and number eight sign is owned by Mars. Then after number eight, we have 12 Rashis or 12 zodiac signs. So number eight, now we will move to number nine, which is Sagittarius, which is owned by Jupiter, which is denoted as number nine. Then we come down to two Rashis, which are Capricorn and Aquarius. Both are owned by Saturn, and the number are denoted as 10 and 11. So here in front of Saturn, what I can write is the Saturn has two signs or two Rashis. That means that is 10 and 11. Now, if I move forward, we have another Rashi, which is known as Pisces, which is owned by Jupiter and denoted as number 12. Now, if I go back in front of Jupiter, I can say, now Jupiter is having two signs, which is number 9 and which is number 12. So I will put it as 9 and 12. And Moon, we have seen it is having a single sign, which is number 4. I will keep it as number 4. And Sun is only having a single sign, which is known as number 5. I will keep it as number 5. Now I will say that Rahu and Ketu, these are the two planets, they are not allotted any signs. But in some cases, they are allotted some signs, but we don't take them as they are allotted any signs in KP astrology. So there is no a proper text which says that they really have any signs. So that's why in KP, we didn't take them or ask them to own any signs, okay? So what we say is, whenever they are there in any signs, then they will give the result of that particular sign. So is there any questions which we already covered at this moment?
No, sir, I'm good.
Okay. Now, we have understand, I've talked about zodiac sign, I've talked about planet. So planet represents as graha, which is like grasping, okay? Now, why I'm saying every time Rashi, because Rashi is having a meaning which is not again translated properly in zodiac sign. Rashi means collection. Rashi meaning collection, okay? It's a collection of what? It's a collection of stars. Or astrological peripherals, you can say. So Rashi is a combination. And every Rashi has an owner. So we need to memorize these things. If I talk about Aries, you should know it is number 1 and is owned by Mars. If I ask you, okay, Venus is having which other Rashis? So I will say Venus is having two Rashi. One is Taurus, which is denoted by number 2. Another is Libra, which is denoted as number 7. So these numbers which we need to memorize properly. Now, if I move forward, we will have 27 nakshatras. What happens is, when we discussed about Rashi, Graha, and now there are some nakshatras also important while doing the analysis. In KP astrology, we always believe that nakshatra is the key factor. And nakshatra has its own power. So when a planet, we can treat as a planet as a light source, okay? So it is throwing a light to an object. Let's say this is one object. Now, this is a planet. We are denoting this as a planet. So let's say we put a filament here, okay? Which is red in color. So this white light, when it is hitting here, so it will mix the color, which is red, white plus red, okay? And it converts to a color which may be red, or if we mix the colors, we may form into a different color. But what I want to explain is, we can treat this layer as a nakshatra. So nakshatra is going to give the exact result, and it will also add its own results to the planet. Okay, so that is what we need to understand, why nakshatra is important. Because nakshatra is going to give its own power. So when we, let's say we want to calculate a result of a planet, we always need to add the result of nakshatra. Then equals to the result, that will be the exact result given by the planet. That we will understand later in detail. So we have 27 nakshatras, and in KP we use all the nakshatras to do the predictions. So we treat that every nakshatra is being having a lord, and lords are denoted as planets. So every planet has its own influences, so they will mix their influences to the planet to give the results. So we will see the example and we will see understand that. To understand a quick calculation, when we talk about a full zodiac, this zodiac is going to cover like 360 degrees. So this whole zodiac is covered into 12 Rashi. And this 12 Rashi is equals to 360 degrees. So if I break one Rashi is equal to 30 degrees. So if I multiply 30 degree into 12, it again comes to 360. Now, if I talk about the nakshatra, just to understand a little bit of calculation of nakshatra. A nakshatra is having a size of 13 degree 20 minutes. We further divided into like we have 27 nakshatra. We further divided this nakshatra in four parts, which is single part is 3 degree 20 minutes. A single part which we denoted as pada. Pada in the sense what? It's also denoted as charan. Steps. We say that every nakshatra has its own steps, and every nakshatra has four pada or four charans or four steps. Okay. So if we say 27 nakshatra, okay, is equal to four charan multiplied by 27, which is equivalent to 360 degree, then we can also say it is equals to 108 pada. So that means 108 pada is equals to 27 nakshatra, which is 4 multiplied by 27, which is 360 degree. So all the things we need to treat it as like it is covering the 360 degree. So this 108 coming with four charans or four steps of nakshatra. when we are multiplying them to the 27, we come to a number which is 108. So that's why this 108 is covering the whole 360 degree. That's why we use this number to chant the mantras. Mantra is one of the form of doing remedy. We always know, if you do a quick research in Google, then you will see that sounds are having a power of healing. And every sound is having its own vibration. Right? So right now, whatever I'm saying to you, probably you are able to understand because you know that particular language. So you're not bother about understanding the vibration of these conversations. But if we chant a particular sound which is known as a mantra, we don't know the meaning exactly, but still we want to grasp the energy and the vibration of that mantra. So those vibrations are going to heal ourselves. That is why even in the past, you will search in the Google and you will see that people have built devices which can produce sound to kill people. So sound has a power, or sound vibrations has a power to impact our body, soul and mind. So that's why mantra is having very good powers to really give you good results or improve your bad positions of the planet. But it is important that we tuned ourselves to chant mantra properly. Because if you are not chanting it, so it is not affecting you. If you chant wrongly, and it may produce bad results as well. So that's why when we see in ancient ages, in Gurukul, everybody, like nowadays what happens is in school, I don't know, when we were studying, we were chanting the tables, right? Every student is shouting the tables to remember it. So like that, every student in Gurukul, they always chant mantras so that they can practice, and they come to a level where they can chant them accurately. So these are the practice which comes, and astrology is a practice which comes with to a level of accuracy with proper practice. So as much you do practice, it is going to come better. Okay, it will progress in a better form. So now, if I move further, so we have understood that we are targeting like 360 degree here, and every nakshatra is having 108 padas. Like every nakshatra is having 4 pada. In total, it is having 108 pada, which is covering 360 degree. So we'll use this pada. That's why we discussed it. When we will see where we are using it. Just to remember, one pada is 3 degree 20 minutes. Now, what we will do is we will understand one more simple calculation of a horary number of 249. Okay. So we'll come to a understanding of horary number 249. So how it came, a 249 number. So we'll understand that. But before that, we need to understand the elements and rashis which are owning elements. So when we talk about elements, so we have 5 elements, but rashis are divided into few elements which are as fire, earth, air, water. So we are using 4 elements, and as you know that every rashi is having a number, so we will mark it as like 1, 2, 3, 4. Then again we will do a division. 5, 6, 7, 8. Then again a separation. 9, 10, 11, 12. So these are divided into 3 parts, and each part is 120 degree. So these are fire elements, these are earthy elements, these are airy element, and these are watery element. So in short, if we talk about fire elements, are having aggression in them. If we talk about the fire element is having aggression. Fire is instant. Fire is active. So like that, so these rashis are also having a characteristics of these elements. If we talk about earth, earth is a solid material. It doesn't move very much. So we can say that these peoples generally are slow moving, or they are fixed or they can be lazy. It depends on their placement, but they have a tendency of being lazy. If you talk about airy sign, so air is again a quick moving planet, a quick moving element. So these Rashis and the people who fall in these Rashis, they will have a different set of energies like air. So they will be very quick moving. Always they will be, their decisions will be difficult to finalize because air is moving. So they always think, okay, I will do this, I will do that. But the thing is, they will not able to fix their decisions, or they will feel difficulties to finalize, to pick a single thing what they want to do. If we talk about water, water is always flowing. It's again a quick or a movable thing, but a water is having emotions. So these people are carrying emotions. But slowly and gradually, if you see, every Rashis has an owner. So that owner is also going to have its own energies. So they will blend their energies to the Rashis. So that will also form a different sort of characteristic. If I say the number one is treated by Mars, as we know, the number one is owned by Mars. So Mars is aggressive nature planet. It's basically a fiery nature. It has a heat, it has a power, it has an aggression. So it will blend its heat, power and aggression in the Rashi. The people will very instant to react to the things. They don't bother what is going to happen later, but still they will react to that particular situation. So if I talk about number five, it is owned by Sun. The Sun is again a king, a royal substance. So it will have its own pride. It will have the aggression. It will have the ego. If you talk about Jupiter, Jupiter is a benefic planet and it is very polite because it is carrying knowledge. Due to fire, probably he will have aggression, but still it is carrying a knowledge. That's why he know how to tackle the aggression. So that is why how they are different. If we talk about Taurus, it is owned by Venus. So Venus is a beautiful planet. They don't really bother about other people. They enjoy on their own life. Until unless anybody is pinning them or anybody is trying to make them unhappy, they will not react till then. If we talk about Mercury, that is also an earthy element. But the thing is, Mercury is having a calculation power. So generally number six people, they do a very good calculation that, okay, if I speak to that particular person, do I get any benefit? If I spend time with that particular person, do I get any benefit? So until unless they are getting any benefit, they calculate and then only they will interact. The way of interaction, it depends on their calculation, what they feel about that particular person. So Mercury is mathematics, Mercury is calculation, Mercury is analytical power. Saturn. Numbers for 10 is owned by Saturn. Okay. So Saturn is a planet which is stubborn in nature. We will see the characteristic of the planets. But as it is an earthy element, it is, we can say, Capricorn is the most difficult Rashi or a zodiac sign to tackle with. because this is a place where we can say like this, it's having so many up and downs. If you want to walk to a place or a floor which is not smooth, then probably we will feel unhappy, or we will be very tired very quickly, right? Because this Capricorn sign is going to take away lots of energy to achieve or to reach to a destination. Like that, so whenever this Capricorn sign is placing into a particular bhava or in a particular house, which we again talk about it just after this, then what happens is this Capricorn sign is going to give you difficulties. So you will see, yes, wherever Capricorn sits, you will face difficulties, and Capricorn is going to ask you for more efforts because it is Saturn. So Saturn is a planet which controls karma. It always loves to give you karma and hard work. Saturn loves hard work. Unless you are not doing hard work, Saturn is not willing to give you the results. Saturn always wants to be in discipline. Follow the rules, follow the law, as the law is also a significator of Saturn and Jupiter. Why Jupiter? Basically, we will talk about it later, because Jupiter is a guidance or rules which we create in a document, that is Jupiter. Every constitution have its own rules and regulations. So those rules and regulations which we publish, that is Jupiter. And following the discipline is Saturn. So that's why Saturn and Jupiter combination is basically for law. If we talk about number three is owned by Mercury. Again, whenever Mercury comes in, these guys are pure business guys. They have a very good business mind. They know how to speak, how to talk. In Kal Purush Kundli, what is Kal Purush Kundli? If you talk about a chart, okay, I will explain the way the chart looks, but the thing is, I just want to show you a simple thing, that whenever a chart starts with number one, it treated as Kal Purush Kundli, and we go anti-clockwise, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, okay. So in Kal Purush Kundli, we will see that 1, 2, 3, third house is coming in the third level. And this house, generally, when we come to the house characteristics, this house generally comes in third, which denotes communication. So they are very powerful communicator. Number three, it is owned by Mercury, and Mercury is a karaka of communication. So they are generally very powerful communicator. So you will see, when you want to do business, you need to be a very good communicator. Until and unless you are doing a proper communication, no use. Your customer is not going to buy the product from you until and unless you will make him understand this is a valuable product for him and he cannot live without it. Yeah? So then people will say, okay, I will buy it. So this is the magic of Mercury and the magic of Gemini sign. And if you talk about again Libra, which is owned by Venus. The Venus is again a beautiful planet. It's like a beautiful fragrance, airy sign. It's fragrance. You have a beautiful candles which are having a good fragrance. You have a perfume, you have a deo. They all form of Libra, because Libra is an airy sign. If we talk about number 11 again owned by Saturn. And this is air, which is, we can say, pollution, carbon dioxide, or we can say a sulfur. So it is very hard to digest these two signs because it requires testing, a hard work. Saturn always gives test to the people. So when you come out of the test, then you will get a good result, right? So then we will see how much you have done the hard work in previous life or in this life. After test only, we will able to see, because the result is going to come after the test only. So Saturn is the planet which is going to give you test. Also, it is going to give you the result. So that is why every people are scared of Saturn. Oh God, how am I to tackle? They always pray to Lord Saturn. Watery sign is the next level of element where we have three signs. What are they? They are Cancer, which is owned by Moon. So Moon is a pure form of water or a liquid. Water or liquid which we can consume, like we can say like Moon is denoted as river water. Moon is denoted as milk. So these peoples are very, very emotional. If you talk about excessive emotion, then Moon, this Cancer signs. So they are having excessive emotion. If I talk about the Scorpio, that is again a watery sign. But the thing is, it is a watery sign and it is having the influence of Mars. So what is the influence of Mars? So Mars is aggression, Mars is power, Mars is a guy which is a military guy. So that means, so Mars is going to have the power of dominating. Like if I want to do a domination, then number 8 people are very good at doing domination. They don't want anyone standing in front of them. So this is what the Mars is going to do. If we talk about the water in a pond, which is stable water, that is number 8, which is Scorpio sign. A flowing water like river, that is Moon. And water which is having a high density of oxygen, because Jupiter is a karaka of oxygen. So if any water is having a high density of oxygen, that water is Jupiter. This Pisces sign is also having Jupiter, because why? Jupiter is a Jeev karaka. Jupiter is a Jeev Karaka, so that's why it is going to have a power of giving life. So any question in this?
Sir, one question. So irrespective of planets, Earth. All these are basically by the planet they own, right? For example, 1 and 8 has almost the same character, because those are owned by Mars, right? Aggressive. But so where we actually use these elements, element categorization?
See, what happens is, if we talk about Mars, so Mars is having 2 Rashis, one is falling in fire and one is falling in water. So always water, the flow of water is slow than fire. Fire is quick, more fast. That means what I want to say is, let's talk about the reaction. The Aries guy is going to react very quickly. Generally what happens is, if there is a fight, there is a debate, then what happened is the Aries guys come into front right away and say, I don't like this, how you are doing this. So he will try to tell you and try to dominate. Now if you talk about number 8. So what happens is, number 8 people, they are not going to blast straight away. First they will try to what happens when we fill a water in a balloon? What happens? It stores, and then it blasts. So like that, the characteristic is different because it is water. So when the water is locked in a huge level, then it can impact the dam. And when the dam is broken, then it can demolish anything. So like that. Okay. So we need to use a little bit of elements to understand how it will be. Yes, the characteristic of the planet will influence it, obviously, because if we see moon, it's very delicate, very light, emotion. And again, Jupiter is having an emotion, but it also not leaving its knowledge. He will feel, okay, I need to help Mohit. But still he will feel that, okay, I need to help him, but do I have that much money so that I can help him? That is Jupiter, Pisces. I'm very emotionally attached with you, but still I'm a Pisces guy. So I will see my pocket as well. But if you are a Cancer guy, so probably you will see your pocket later. First, he will try to help you. And if it is a Mars guy, then what we will do is, till it is not really emergency, he is not going to produce anything for you. Okay, this is how. So slowly and gradually you need to blend the elements as well as blend the power of the planet and the characteristics of the planet.
Got it. So basically it's a composition.
Yeah, it's a composition. Because when we try to learn astrology, when I was thinking about learning astrology, someone told me, okay, you need to know physics, you need to know chemistry, you need to know mathematics. So I said, so many things I need to know to learn astrology. So he said, yes. So now I slowly understand that, yes, we need to understand the nature of the water. We also need to understand, if we do a deep dive, we also need to understand the chemical composition of the water as well. Like if you talk about Jupiter, it is having a oxygen, right? So water is having a chemical combination of what? Oxygen. So each and everything has a meaning when we derived in that this Jupiter is having a oxygen, and Jupiter is treating, as you can say, Jupiter is water, right? Watery planet, watery sign, Pisces. Now Jupiter is a karaka of air. Even air is having oxygen. Yeah. So like that, every planet has its own characteristic. We will come back to that as well. But the thing is, we need to understand that there are four divisions of the elements, and we have divided the zodiac signs in three divisions of 120 degree, 120 degree and 120 degree. And then we can come back and see how they are calculated. Okay. Now to our next level, let me draw a chart and tell you how to see the houses and how to see the Rashis in a chart. So what we do is we use a diamond chart. It also says a North Indian chart. It also denoted as diamond chart. So to draw a diamond chart, we need to draw a square or a rectangle, and then we need to draw like this. So generally in diamond chart, the first box denoted as number first house, okay? Or house is equal to bhava. Okay. Bhava means expression. House does not really explain you about bhava. Bhava is expression. Okay. If you want to express anything, then I need to have a bhava. So that's why every bhava is having a significators or expressions. Let's say first house is express about yourself. Yeah. So we will count them as anti-clockwise. One, then two, this is second bhava, this is third, this is fourth, this is five, we will say this is sixth house, 7,000, 8,000, 9,000, 10,000, 11,000, 12,000. So each bhava is having its own significance. We will come back to that. But the thing is, when you see a chart, I will open a single chart here, then I can explain very easily. So now you can see this, as I said, this is first house, this is second house, this is third house, this is fourth house, this is fifth house, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But you can see the number is written here, number 3. This is number 2. So what that mean? As we learned previously, every Rashi or a zodiac sign is having a number. So you need to memorize this number. If in the first house or first bhava it is written number 3, then what? Then we can say number 3 is Gemini sign. Okay. So this is a guy who is Gemini ascendant. This is called as ascendant, a starting point. Ascendant means it is a starting point. Starting point of the chart. So wherever you can see ASC or wherever you see LA, these LA stands for Lagna, or you will see a mark like this. They denotes that this is the starting point. And first house is always a starting point. We cannot start from 12. We cannot start from 4. Always we need to start from number 1. If you talk about the house. So this is number 3, which denotes this is a Gemini sign and ascendant is Gemini. You can see we are seeing a chart which name as Rashi chart. So there are two type of chart when we are going to analyze. One chart is Rashi, another is Bhava chart. So probably tomorrow we will talk about Bhava chart. But at this moment we need to understand about Rashi chart. So Rashi chart denotes what? The Rashi chart is going to tell you, okay, this is first house and it is owning Gemini sign in the first house. If we talk about the sign, I will see this is second house and Cancer sign is owned by second house. This is third house and third house Lord is Leo and it is Sun. It is fourth house, then fourth house sign Lord is Mercury, which is Virgo. This is fifth house and the sign Lord is Venus, which is Libra. This is sixth house and the sign Lord is Mars. This is number 8, which denotes Scorpio. If we talk about seventh house, it is number 9. Which is a sign Lord is Jupiter and it is Sagittarius. This is number 10, which is Capricorn. That means what? The Lord is Saturn. And this is 8th house. This is 9th house. And this is Aquarius sign and again the Lord is Saturn. So this is house number 10 and the sign is 12. So we can say this is Pisces sign, which is Lord of Jupiter. And this one is number 1. Number 1 is denoted by Mars and Aries. Now number 2 is owned by Venus and it is Taurus. Yeah. So this is how you need to see. Okay, this is house number one. This is house number two. If I ask which sign is there in house number seven, what you will say?
It's number nine, Sagittarius, Jupiter.
Jupiter, correct. So like that, we need to understand which sign is owned by which house. Okay, so this is how we will count, like 1 to 12. There are 12 Rashi. There are 12 Bhava. Or they are also known as house. They are also known as signs. S-I-G. And we have 27 Nakshatras. Okay. So these are the component which we are going to use to do astrology. We have two type of chart. One is Rashi chart, which is this, and another is Bhava chart. We will see that like this. This is Bhava chart. So tomorrow I will explain what is Rashi, what is Bhava. But the thing is, what is the difference basically? We will understand. The first attempt, we need to understand what is Rashi chart. So today, which we have covered, is there any questions?
No, sir, I'm good. Thank you.
Okay. So we will continue tomorrow then. Okay.
Sure.
And I will upload this video and share it to you so that you can recall what we have discussed.
Sure.